This afternoon. Now on to the second division of the first heat and the morning line. We have Crown Sweep starting at 15-1 with Carl Allen. Napolitano at 9-5 with Bill O'Donnell. Classic Jazz is at 12-1. Go Get Lost 4-1 with John Hogan. Waikiki Beach is at 6 with Jim Doherty. Buckfinder at 2 with Ronnie Waples. C. Lewis Lomont at 15 with Jan Nordin. And Cotton Hanover 20-1 with Dick Richardson Jr. in the bike. And they're moving on to the track for this, the sixth race of the Meadowlands card in the second division of the first heat. And here is number one, Crown Sweep, who seems to be all or nothing at all. Never second or third. He seems to win or do nothing. What about this one, Ellie?
He did win a three-year-old open trot here at the Meadowlands last week. He has over 102,000 made. He draws the rail nets, always helps a lot, Dave.
And following on to the racetrack, number two, Napolitano. Napolitano, the bad luck horse in this field. Bill O'Donnell drives as he did last time. He was boxed in, just nowhere to go. I guess he's looking for some better luck today.
Well, he did finish third in that race. The Houghton stable is sending this colt into the race in peak form. He has 10 starts this year, and all 10 he was on the board, first, second, and third.
Classic Jazz ready to move on to the racetrack. And Ellie, this is the biggest question mark in the field for me. This horse took the Montreal trot, but has been off the board in the other nine races.
Well, it is quite rare to win a $186,000 race and then be off the board in the rest of your starts. But the McNichol and Caraluzzi team, they had plenty of great trotters, but this horse here faces some awful stiff competition.
Number four is Go Get Lost, a versatile and certainly durable sort. He has kept his form since he started really in the winter and just come on right through 19 straight races with lots and lots of money paychecks.
He has 11 wins out of those 19 starts, Dave. He's a New Jersey Sire Stakes winner. He made a break out of the gate 2 weeks ago against Mack, recovered and still finished fourth. I don't think you can overlook this horse.
And remembering the victory that we just saw of Mack Lobel, here is the last horse to defeat Mack Lobel. It's Waikiki Beach, and Jim Doherty drives.
That was his biggest claim to fame, beating his stablemate. He has over 200,000 made life, but his form hasn't been quite as good as when he was a two-year-old. He's just not quite the same as a three-year-old.
And Buckfinder is certainly developing into a fine racehorse. He turned in his fastest mile ever last time out in the Beacon course, but didn't win the race. Here is Buckfinder with Ron Waples.
Well, I'll tell you, the biggest question in my mind still is, can he beat Mack? It was a question last year as two-year-olds. Now this year, he was locked in against him, and he never shook loose. He finished third. He appears to be at his best, and I think he's the horse to beat in this division.
And Ron Waples is at his best. He took the Breeders' Crown last night with Sugarcane Hanover. Here is C. Lewis Lomont. 10 racetracks in his last 11 races. The well-traveled colt driven by Jan Nordin.
Well, you know, speaking of well-traveled, back in June, this colt was parked the whole mile in a stakes event at Scioto Downs, winning in 57-4. He just doesn't seem to be as good since then. He draws outside, and he's going to need an awful lot of racing luck in here.
And a horse who's drawn bad post positions in his last several starts, Cotton Hanover, again on the outside, Dick Richardson Jr. in the bike.
His recent form against this caliber really hasn't been that bad, but you know, Dave, when you draw the eight hole, you're really at a big disadvantage when the horses you have to beat are inside of you.
So that's the entire field for this second division of the first heat. Well, as this octet of three-year-old trotters gets ready to go the mile in the second division of the first heat, a quick check of the odds board shows that Crown Sweep is at 70-1, one of the two real long shots in this contest. Napolitano, who is getting bet down heavily in the final minutes before post, is at 6-5. Classic Jazz is up to 45. Go Get Lost is 2.5-1. Waikiki Beach holds at 6. The second choice in the crowd of about 25,000 here this afternoon is Buckfinder at 9-5. And then two long shots on the outside, C. Lewis Lomont from post 7, and on the far outside, Cotton Hanover at 60-1. Stan, for the longest time, we had four horses who were right there at 5-2. They couldn't decide who to make the favorite.
Well, it's decided on Napolitano, but it's interesting because a year ago, of the eight horses in this particular race, Napolitano won less money than the other seven. Buckfinder, on the other hand, was for a while the world's fastest two-year-old trotter last year. And he, of course, has not come back to the form of then, although he has earned $108,000. Go Get Lost has won $211,000, earned most of it racing older horses, won the Statue of Liberty here at the Meadowlands against the best from Europe, and in doing so, engendered some second-guessing from horsemen who wondered whether it was smart to race a horse against older horses than three-year-olds early in the year when you were hoping for the Hambletonian. The answer to their question, of course, will be forthcoming in just a few moments.
Some interesting human stories here, too. Driving Cotton Hanover on the far outside is Dick Richardson, Jr., and he certainly knows about upsets. He was driving Marauder when Nihilator was defeated by Dick Richardson, Jr. in the Adios.
He's a good trotting trainer, too. And an interesting story, of course, Chuck Sylvester, who trains Mac Lobel, also trains Waikiki Beach. And Waikiki Beach, I believe, might have been the only horse to beat Mac Lobel when that horse stayed flat last year.
And as the trotters are called to the gate, we're going to get ready to go up to the track announcer here at the Meadowlands, Tom Durkin, for the call of the sixth race on the card and the second division of the first heat. Tom?
Thank you, Dave. Well, the big three to watch here, Napoletano, who is the favorite as they come to the starting line, Go Get Lost and Buck Finder. Here they come, and we have a breaker here. Crown Sweep is off stride, but it will not be a recall. He broke after the recall point. And they're off, and Crown Sweep is on a break as the field moves for the first turn, and Cotton Hanover, with a quick early move, angles over to the inside to grab the rail and the early lead. Napoletano gets the pocket early, and Go Get Lost is now parked out third. At the inside, Classic Jazz is now trotting fourth, a gap of four to Waikiki Beach, and then it's Buckfinder, C. Lewis Lomont, and the early breaker, Crown Sweep, and he's still off stride. They're moving over to the quarter with Cotton Hanover in front. They trot the opening quarter in 28 2/5 seconds. And here comes Go Get Lost now. John Hogan puts him in gear, and they're up to take the lead as Napoletano comes off the rail. Up the backstretch, Go Get Lost now has taken the lead. Napoletano coming after him from the outside. Napoletano now taking over. Go Get Lost now yields and races second. Cotton Hanover, the early leader, is now back settled in third. A gap of 2.5 to Classic Jazz fourth. Waikiki Beach is racing fifth. He's about 7 lengths off the lead. And then it's Buckfinder and C. Lewis Lomont. And the half in 57 4/5 seconds. Napoletano is the leader as they move into the turn. Go Get Lost in close pursuit. Mickey McNichol takes Classic Jazz off the rail. And they're on the move now on the outside third. On the inside, Cotton Hanover is right there. Then 2.5 lengths back to Waikiki Beach. Farther back, it's Buckfinder on the outside and C. Lewis Lomont at the rail. Go Get Lost now comes after Napoletano, and those two are dueling as they turn for home. 3/4 in 1:28 1, and now the field turns for home. Napoletano holding on to a short lead. Go Get Lost is full out to stay with him, but Napoletano puts it in another gear in mid-stretch, and he's opened up now by 2.5 lengths. He's now in front by 3.5. On the inside, Cotton Hanover now driving hard in second. Go Get Lost has dropped out of it. On the outside, Waikiki Beach, and they're coming to the finish, and it's going to be Napoletano to win it decisively. The final time was 1:56 2. Bill O'Donnell took the lead as they moved into the backstretch, fought off Go Get Lost, and held off Cotton Hanover at the end to win it, coming nowhere close to that impressive time of Mac Lobel in the first division, but he is nonetheless the winner in 1:56 2. Dave, back to you.
Napoletano, trained by Don Miller from the Houghton stable, and Bill O'Donnell in the bike. This is the horse that had bad luck last time out in the Beacon Course Trot and finished third, full of trot, but nowhere to go behind horses. Having no trouble like that this afternoon and coming home as the 6-5 favorite, let's watch the stretch drive again. Napoletano and Bill O'Donnell in command, setting up a really terrific finale here this afternoon. He looks over his right shoulder. There is nobody around, and Napoletano breezes to victory in 1:58 2. The unofficial winner of the second division of the first heat and the top five finishers here will return for the next heat on this beautiful hot afternoon from the Meadowlands. And we'll be back with more after this. It's official, and the winning price is Napolitano, $5, $3.80 and $2.60. And he paced the mile in 156-2, 156-2, not 158-2, as I said. Cotton Hanover, 28.40 and 5.60 to show. And Waikiki Beach finished third, $3.40 for the show spot. Well, form certainly is holding this afternoon. The leading drivers of the meet, Campbell and O'Donnell. Campbell took the first division, and in the winner's circle now, here's, well, first of all, let's check the official order of finish top to bottom. Napolitano, Cotton Hanover second, Waikiki Beach third, Go Get Lost was fourth, C. Lewis Lomont fifth, Classic Jazz sixth, Buckfinder was seventh, and Crown Sweep finished eighth. The top five come back for the finale, or at least for the next heat. And let's go to the winner's circle now, and Bill O'Donnell with Alan Kirshenbaum.
Like you said, Dave, you expect when you do two interviews here at the Meadowlands to do one with John Campbell, one with Billy O'Donnell. Billy, you only drove Napolitano in his last race for the first time. Did you expect him to be a dominating sort of trotter?
Well, and with that feel there, I did. The night I drove him, I got locked in the whole way, and I never got out until real late, and he was full of trotting. That was a good, easy race to bring him into this race. You know, it was only 2 weeks ago, and, yeah, I hoped he would anyway.
We're going to look at a replay of the race, Billy. Maybe you'll talk it through. We'll pick it up right when you made your move to the top with Napolitano. Didn't want to sit on the inside any longer?
Well, no, Dick Richards went out there fast with Cotton Hanover and got the front, and John Hogan kept working his way up to the front, and he'd been used, you know, quite a ways past the quarter, so I just slipped out, and, you know, hopefully he was looking for cover. And then from there on, I kind of got it, you know, shut down pretty good, the third quarter, 30 seconds at a piece, and the last one, 28-1, and he was really strong.
Even though there was quite a bit of movement through that middle half, the fractions were kind of soft. Were you surprised at that?
Yes, I was, kind of. But, you know, the two best horses at that point were up close, you know. And, you know, when you get a race like that, there's, you know, the long shots are not really coming at you because they're just going to tire themselves out.
You've driven Buckfinder enough to know that he usually has a real good late kick. Did you ever have any thoughts to the fact that he might be coming at the end of the mile?
Well, I never really thought of it. My horse felt good and, you know, was full of trot at the head of the stretch, and I spoke to him on, and, you know, he trotted good, strong, right straight through the wire.
You certainly saw Go Get Lost race a bit here at the Meadowlands earlier in the year, and he's tailing you pretty closely. Do you sense that he's a strong horse at this point or not so strong?
No, I think he felt pretty good, you know, out there. We weren't going much right there, and then right there at the head of the stretch, I just kind of spoke to mine on, and, you know, he just couldn't keep up with him.
He trotted home in 28-1, Napolitano did, just a tick slower than Mac Lobel trotted his final quarter. Do you think you're trying to reserve anything here for the second heat at this point?
Oh yeah, no question. You know, 56-2 or whatever it was, or one is, you know, today with the hot weather and the track is really fast, it's not what you call a real blazing mile. And even Mac Lobel, 54, he did it with ease, you know. So, you know, both of them are coming back into the final fresh.
We'll see if you can beat Mac Lobel in the final. Good luck. Let's go back to Dave Johnson.